When we work with networks and with advertisers with an addressable capability, we can literally go in and control the number of times any particular household in that target audience sees an ad. Addressable advertising is the ability for us to place an ad on behalf of our client into a household based on the interest and demographics of that household and ensure that the advertising is seen regardless of what they're viewing, when they're viewing it, whether it's live or in playback. Thousands of campaigns, hundreds of active clients. So this is way beyond the test phase. Addressable is a multi-billion dollar business in the United States alone today. Programmatic is very different than addressable in my view, in that it is the method for the transaction of the advertising. In the digital space, for example, programmatic is the most common form of transaction, where a buyer and a seller meet each other in a programmatic marketplace, and they transact the acquisition and the sale of that ad inventory. Whereas addressable is the delivery of the ad inventory to a target audience. Here's how an addressable campaign can work. A client approaches us, and they understand who their target audience is. They may have a custom list of the attributes that make up that target. They provide that data to us. We then put that into a third-party safe haven who then batches that target audience against our addressable footprint. We don't need to know or want to know all the details of that target audience for privacy reasons. In creating a premium marketplace for buyers and sellers, you have to be brand safe. In fact, I would suggest that premium content is less about whether it's long form or short form or scripted or unscripted or user-generated or not. It has everything to do with brand safety. We need to make sure that the brand can participate and engage with the consumer within that content and keep their brand safe. The biggest resistance to addressable right now, in part, has been the shift of moving to a CPM reduction supply chain type of management process to a ROI outcome-based investment process. So getting people to understand that this is an investment into a better outcome, that's been a shift. A new and important benefit of addressable technology is simply frequency capping. The benefit to the viewer is they're seeing a more relevant ad. They're not seeing any more advertising than what they would have seen. They're just going to see a more relevant ad. The benefit for the brand is that they're engaging with an elusive portion of their target. If they use this technology and one of their competitors doesn't, it's very reasonable to assume they have a significant competitive advantage. This is another evolution of addressable technology. We do not want to create a bad consumer experience from an advertising perspective, and we don't want to create waste and oversaturation selling advertising to marketers. We're disincented to have that happen, and we're incented to get it right.